Hey guys, what is up? It's Reaper Jinkai here, and I am back with a new type of video. I know with this type of cover and this kind of setting that it is normally a top 5 video. We are doing something similar but different. As you read from the title, this is a Who Did It Best video. And this time it's going to be bird type Pokemon, but I'm not doing all bird type Pokemon because that'd be way too huge of a video, but I am going to do the starter birds of each region. Now, I should probably explain who did it the best video is. Basically, what we are doing in this video is we are taking the 6 bird Pokemon, the 6 starting birds of each region, and we are going to look at kind of relevant moves as they level up, and they only get their level up moves and their TM moves. This is pretty much just seeing which Pokemon would be best for a playthrough. If Pokemon gave you an option of picking any one of the six in a single region, which one would be the best to pick up? Now, a couple of rules are, of course, since this is going to be for a normal playthrough, hidden abilities are not allowed. So I'm sorry, Talonflame, you're not going to instantly win just because you have Gale Wings. Another thing to keep in mind is I will not be including Fly as one of the moves that I list because it's a given. They're all going to have Fly. That's what your playthrough bird Pokemon's for. Is there anything I'm missing? Oh, I am not including Mega Pidgeot. Pidgeot gets its base form, that is it. Because chances are you're not as good as Mega Pidgeot is on a playthrough. I do not see people using him or using Mega Pidgeot before other Megas. And also, it's kind of an unfair advantage, because it would have been like, yeah, guys, Mega Pidgeot's a thing, so it wins. So no HMs, no tutor moves. Sorry, again, with Mega Pidgeot, or with Pidgeot, you're not going to see Heat Wave. Pidgeot does not get that by level up, it does not get it by TM. Not getting it. The last thing that I'm going to mention is this is their movesets, TMs, and stats from 6th gen. I did not sit there and again with Pidgeot sit there and go, okay, what did Pidgeot get in 1st gen? What did Noctowl get in 2nd gen? What did Swellow get in 3rd gen? And so on and so forth. Because obviously they have made more moves. They have adjusted the Pokemon accordingly as the games have advanced. So the only fair way to do this is to look at everything they have from 6th gen. We're going to be going from 1st gen to 6th gen in chronological order. I have some notes to my right to kind of help me with what I want to talk about. And without any further ado, let's begin. Oh, before I forget, none of these pictures are mine. I found them all on Google. If you know, there's little things here. I tried to use like in-show pictures for all the birds besides the beginning and end picture. But anyways, now let's begin. Starting with Gen 1 Pidgeot. Some things about Pidgeot is since it are its two abilities are Kenai and Tangled Feet. Now, if you don't know what those do, Kenai basically stops accuracy from being lowered, and Tangled Feet makes it to where when you are confused, your evasionness goes up by 20%. Personally, for a playthrough, I would rather go with Tangled Feet than Kenai. I gotta take that back. I'd rather go with Kenai before Tangled Feet because both of those statuses are switch out and they're fixed. So Kenai would be more useful because I feel like you run into Sand Attack and Smoke Screen and stuff like that more often than Confuse Rays, at least early game. So for stats, Pidgeot has an HP of 83, an attack of 80, a defense of 75, special attack of 70, special defense of 70, speed of 91, and for a grand total of a 469. So, pretty good. The one thing I do not like about Pidgeot while looking at its stats is it really doesn't excel in a single area. They're all kind of clumped together, which is good and bad. I personally like it to where they just excel at one thing in general, or one or two things, because you can just play off of those. With Pidgeot, I feel like there's too much iffy. Like, what? How do I word this? Like, there's too many options for one Pokemon. It's kind of why I don't like using Mew. But anyways, moving on to its level up moves. At level 1, it gets Tackle. At level 9, it gets Gust. Quick Attack at 13. Feather Dance at 27. Wing Attack at 38. I'm going to come back to that in a second. Roost at 44. Tailwind at 50. Mirror Move at 56. And Air Slash at 62. Now, these are not all its moves. I kind of picked relevant moves and stuff that might be useful. If I miss some moves that you guys think are essential or are really good on Pidgeot or any of the Mons in general, please let me know in the comments. This is my first time doing it. I'm not huge into using, or I have not used all these birds to an extensive amount to where I'm like, I know everything that these things are good with. I'm gonna make mistakes. But going back to Wing Attack, it does not get its first real flying type move until level 38. And to me, that is ridiculous. That's, I believe, two or three levels after it evolves. You have to wait, or after it reaches Pidgeot, to get Wing Attack. Which, Wing Attack isn't that great. It's 60 power, 100 accuracy. Basically, until you reach level 38, you are working with Quick Attack. From the moves I listed, that's what you're working with, because his attack stat's a little bit higher than his special attack. You could use Gust too, but you're going to hit harder with Quick Attack. Until you get that Wing Attack, there's not much he gets. And he gets Air Slash at 62. I'm going to say this now because I forgot to mention it at the beginning. I know Pidgeot gets Hurricane at 68. But I cut off the moves that they learn at 65 because this is for playthrough only. So you generally end with anywhere from a 60 to 65, I feel, when you beat the Elite Four. Post-game, you can get up to level 100s. And I'm not talking about post-game. I'm talking in-game. So 65 is where I cut them off. For TMs, he gets a lot of TMs, but I really just narrowed it down to Return and Aerial Ace because, yeah, it gets access to Hyper Beam and Giga Impact, but personally, I find I do not like using recharge moves. And I don't know if that's just a lot of people or if that's just me. If it's just me, let me know, and I'll be sure to throw moves like that onto the next list that I do. But Return is a great move because by the time you get him to that level 38, he's probably going to have max friendship with you. He or she, obviously. But and with Stab on top of that, that's going to hurt. But really, without Move Tutor or anything like that, Return's probably going to be the best move you get in-game. So, I don't know. Moving on, we are going to go to second gens, Noctowl. Now, this is, if you guys do not know, a little fun fact, this is Ash's Noctowl for when he was going through Johto. He got an odd colored one, but I do not think this is what the actual shiny looks like. So that's something cool that if you ever want to go back and watch that old episodes to look for, because it was, I believe, smaller than the average Noctowl, and it was an odd color. It wasn't a shiny, because, well, they never straight up called it a shiny, but anyways, moving on. Noctowl gets the abilities Insomnia and Keen Eye. Now, in this situation, I would probably use Insomnia. I believe there's a Psychic Elite Four in second gen, and Psychic Pokemon, let's be honest, a lot of them carry Hypnosis. So, Insomnia would be really nice. You can switch them out, get the Insomnia. And moving on to stats, HP 100, Attack 50, Defense 50, Special Attack 76, Special Defense 96, and Speed 70 for a grand total of 442. So lower than Pidgeot's, but this is kind of what I was talking about to where I like if it focuses on one or two things. I like how Noctowl focuses on HP and Special Defense. It is quite literally the only starting bird that is more defensive than aggressive. Its defense is, how you say, shit. You do not want this thing to be your a defensive mod, but a special defense mod, I would consider it. 96 is not bad. There are definitely better choices, but for a playthrough, if you were to pick this up, you're going to use it for fly, obviously. But it gets, let's look at its moves. It gets Tackle at level 1, Foresight at level 1, I believe that's what it's called. Hypnosis at 5, Peck at 9, Uproar at 13, Reflect at 17, Confusion 22, Echoed Voice 27, Takedown 32, Air Slash 37, Zen Headbutt 42, Psycho Shift 57, and Roost at 62. I think at like 68 it would get Dream Eater, which my ideal set for this going off of just the level up, if I pushed it to 68, I would give him Hypnosis, Dream Eater, Reflect, and Psycho Shift. Because he's gonna be a defensive mon anyways. So with that Reflect, you can kind of hopefully survive some physical hits. Hypnosis, Dream Eater, you have a way to heal yourself. And Psycho Shift, if you are paralyzed, poisoned, burned, you can get it off you and send it to someone else. Sadly, he does not get it in before level 65, but if I had to give up Dream Eater, I would probably get rid of Reflect for Roost. and get Air Slash instead. Just looking at it on paper. But for TMs, he does get Return, Aerial Ace, Round, Echoed Voice, and Dream Eater. So if you find the Dream Eater TM throughout the game, I don't know if it's post-game or not, then there you would have your set for the Elite Four. Obviously, it's a very defensive set, and I think it could be usable that late game. I have never used one that late, but that's just me. And I think that's going to wrap it up for Noctowl. So let's move on to third gen Swellow. Swellow only gets Guts. Well, it gets Guts and then its hidden ability, but it only gets Guts for what you can use in game, which isn't bad because then you have a switch in for status effects. Because then you do more damage. But HP is 60, attack is 85, defense is 60, special attack is 50, special defense is 50, and speed is 125. I am going to try and talk for a minute while I look up its stat total, because I forgot to write that down. But basically, Swellow isn't incredibly great in anything, but with Guts, if you can get poisoned or burn, or does burn? I think Guts goes through burn. I could be wrong. But if you can get poisoned, then it has the speed that its attack gets increased. 430. 430 is its final stat total. I'm sorry about that. So currently the lowest one that we have. So with 430 base total, level up, it gets Peck at level 1, Quick Attack at 9, Wing Attack at 13, Aerial Ace at 21, Air Slash at 45, and Brave Bird at 51. Brave Bird is an incredible move. If you could get that Guts boosted, you're looking at something that's gonna hurt. It's gonna take lives. Honestly, I took out all the... I think I took out all the, like, Growl and Quick Guard and stuff like that. Because I could be 100% wrong. I'm not a Pokemon master, but I think Quick Guard protects your ally. Yeah, so it's really only good for double battles, which, I mean, granted, in third gen, there was a lot of double battles, but not enough that I would be like, yeah, I'll keep it. For TMs, Return and Aerial Ace, again, with that normal typing, Return is going to do a hurt a lot. Aerial Ace, it gets naturally, so if for some reason you got rid of it and you decide you wanted it back, you got the TM to back you up. Personally, I like Aerial Ace over Wing Attack because they do the same damage, but Aerial Ace can't miss. It just can't. So, for Swellow, I really like Swellow. I've used it a lot, but I've never held on to it for the whole game, I don't think. It's just one of those mons that I don't think its stats hold up to what happens later in game. And honestly, you're getting Thunder Waved more than you're getting Poison Powdered or burned. You're either paralyzed or asleep. And its speed's really the only thing it has going for it if you take away Guts. You need that speed and that attack to utilize Swellow the best. Which, I mean, you can pick up a Flame Orb in game or a Toxic Orb in game, but You really don't use those in game. But that's about all I can say about Swellow. So let's move on to 4th gen Staraptor. Now Staraptor is my favorite bird, but I'm going to do my best to keep biased out of this. Now Staraptor only has one ability, again, Intimidate. So I'd use Intimidate, guys, because I don't get an option. But anyways, HP is 85, attack is a whopping 120, defense is 70, special attack is 50, special defense is 60, and speed is 100, for a grand total of 485, the highest we have seen so far. Just looking at stat-wise, this is really what I was talking about earlier with a Pokemon focusing on one or two things. The special side of Staraptor is garbage. Its defense is not bad, but it's nowhere near what good is considered. And its HP is 85. So it really has that 120 attack and that 100 speed to base to go off of. And that's good in my opinion. Moving on to level up, it gets Tackle, Quick Attack, Wing Attack, or Tackle at 1, Quick Attack at 5, Wing Attack at 9, Aerial Ace at 28, Takedown at 33. When it evolves into Staraptor at 34, it will get Close Combat, and then at 49, it gets Brave Bird. Personally, I would go Aerial Ace, Close Combat, and Brave Bird as set in stone. Those are such good moves. Aerial Ace you got for, oh no, I've been sand attacked 5 times. Well, I'm going to hit you anyways. Close Combat you got for if for whatever reason you're stuck in on a rock type. Coverage for normal types. It does lower your defense and special defense, but to be honest, they weren't doing you much anyways. And then you got Brave Bird, which just hits like a truck. For TMs, Return, Aerial Ace, and Giga Impact, I would every day of the week pick up Return above Giga Impact, but for whatever reason, if you were going to substitute or give Return to somebody else, I would definitely consider Giga Impact. I really don't like two-turn moves, but it's really there for when you need to take something out. You need it gone. I don't know what else to say about Staraptor, so we are going to move on to Unfezant. Now, Unfezant gets Big Pecs or Super Luck. Big Pecs stops your attack from being lowered, and Super Luck increases your critical strike chance by 1. That's a hard choice. I think crits ignore attack drops. If they do, I would go with Super Luck. If they don't, I'd go with Big Pecs. So it kind of comes down to that. For stats, it has an HP of 80, an attack of 115, a defense of 80, a special attack of 65, a special defense of 55, and a speed of 93. Now, remember that special attack for a moment, or for a little bit. Level up, it gets Gust at 1, Quick Attack at 11, Air Cutter at 15. So its first real flying type move, because I don't consider Gust like a legitimate move. Like, it's in the game, it's real, but I don't see it as something like a level 20 would still be using. Air Cutter at 15, Roost at 18, Air Slash at 32, Razor Wind at 38, and Sky Attack at 65. It's only powerful physical move that it gets by level up is Sky Attack, and it takes a turn to charge. I would definitely not. I would probably have to grab it. If I could not use TMs, I would have to grab Sky Attack. Because with a special attack stat of 65, you're not going to do anything with Air Cutter, Air Slash, and Razor Wind. I mean, who looked at Unfezant and goes, you know, an attack of 115 is amazing. Let's not give him any physical moves to level 65, though. Who sat down and thought that? Another one, it's a bird. Why doesn't it get wing attack? This Pokemon's stats, the stat total is 488, by the way, which is the highest we have seen out of the five. And it can't do anything with its highest stat. It has three TMs that I would recommend, which are Return, Aerial Ace, and Giga Impact. And then its last slot, I would probably put Roost. And I hate using Giga Impact, and I would put Giga Impact on this. But you're giving up your Return TM, and you're giving up your Aerial Ace TM. Which, again, Aerial Ace is only 60. But you're going to do more damage with it. If it got Wing Attack naturally, I'd say, forget Aerial Ace, I suppose. But you literally have to throw three TMs into this. Three out of this mon's four moves have to be TMs for it to be usable. Well, I mean, it's usable, but to be good in a playthrough. I mean, yeah, you can. I know that's really hard to say, because I know you don't have to use its Pokemon's highest stats to win in a playthrough. But for something that I would be comfortable using and enjoy using, I would personally have to. But that's all I can say about Unfezant. I know there was a lot, and not a lot of it was positive. But we're moving on to the last one, Talonflame. Talonflame only gets Flame Body. Like I said earlier, sorry, no Gale Wings. But HP 78, Attack 81, Defense 71, Special Attack 74, Special Defense 69, and Speed 126, for a grand total of 499, which is ridiculously high for a Pokemon that you find in some of the first Blades of Grass. I really like the speed, because it's going to outspeed 90% of the mons you run across. If not all. But they kind of made it a mixed attacker, because there's six points in between special attack and attack. And they kind of gave speed incredibly high. And then the rest they kind of lowered down to average to below average, with special defense being below average. Which, I mean, that's not bad. looking at it on paper, I'm surprised with how much work it does in PvP. But anyways, looking at its level up, it gets Tackle at 1, Quick Attack at 6, Peck at 10, Flail at 16, Ember at 17, Roost at 25, Razor Wind at 27, Flame Charge at 35, Acrobatics at 44, Steel Wing at 60, and Brave Bird at 64. That is a lot. That is a pretty good move set. Ember, I do not like how it only gets two fire moves by level up when it's a fire flying. Also, real quick, let's talk about that. Every other starting bird has been normal flying, which I would honestly prefer if they were just straight flying. Because really the only thing the normal typing gives them is an immunity to ghost. But in return, they have to be neutral to fighting. Which, fighting is super common in-game and in PvP. But Talonflame keeps that resistance to fighting because it's fire flying, of course. But picks up a few extra weaknesses and so on and so forth. And the four times weak to rock. But then you go to its TMs and it can learn Flamethrower, Fire Blast, Aerial Ace, Flame Charge, Overheat, Incinerate, Acrobatics, and Giga Impact. Giga Impact, I would, you know what? No. Scratch that. Get rid of Giga Impact. I would not give this thing Giga Impact. It gains nothing by getting that move. So, sorry about that. So, Flamethrower and Fire Blast. If you're making a mixed attacker, I would almost give it Overheat. So that you can overheat and then Flame Charge, Acrobatics, whatever you want to do. Brave Bird, even. And yeah. So now we are going to get to the part that we have all been waiting for. Who did it best? Now, this picture has nothing to do with the final decision. This is the only picture I could find that had all six of the birds. So I just want to say that. So don't just look at this and go, Talonflame won. But, so we're going to start from sixth place and work our way up. Sixth place, big surprise, is Unfezant. It just, with what it gets by level up, and how many TMs you have to throw into it to make it good, in my opinion, it's not worth it. I'd rather just keep it at the back of my party, and as soon as I get the flying legendary Zekrom or Reshiram, I get rid of him. In fact, that's what I did. Coming in the number 5 spot is Noctowl, which Noctowl is not bad. It's just, for a normal playthrough, you're normally not going to be worried about a defensive mon. Let's be honest, in a normal playthrough, you guys, unless you're Nuzlocking, you guys are picking Pokemon that you like and picking Pokemon that hit hard. In the number 3, did I do that right? Number 4 spot, yeah, 654, there we go. Swellow. Just because I feel like Swellow depends way too much on Guts to get a large amount of damage out. It does have Brave Bird, which does redeem that. Because Brave Bird's going to do a crap ton of damage if you like it or not. But yeah, the low stats and everything besides speed and an average attack kind of brought it down below the others. Number three is going to be Pidgeot. And Pidgeot is number three because to while normal Pidgeot doesn't have anything necessarily great, it doesn't have anything necessarily bad either. So it's kind of that perfect mon to put in the middle because while it's... What's the word I'm looking for? While it's not... I don't know how I word this. While it's not good, it's not bad. So it's something that I would comfortably use. My biggest complaint is how late it gets wing attack. I actually think you can get aerial ace in the game before you get wing attack. The only other complaint is Pidgey falls off, or I felt Pidgey kind of falls off around level 13, 14. So then you kind of have to switch train it up to level 18. And then I feel like Pidgeotto falls off somewhere around mid-20s. Mid to late 20s, and then you have to grind it up to the level 36. But once you start getting wing attack and the moves past that, you generally start doing fine. Coming in second place is Staraptor. As much as I love Staraptor, I could not give him first. Just because for one of the best things about Pokemon is the option to do different things with each Pokemon. So Staraptor is just attack. You cannot try and special attack it. You cannot try and defense it. You have to make it aggressive. And it kind of takes away that option. So, to where it's a great mon, and I would use it, it would be the first bird Pokemon on my party anytime. I could not give it first. So, yes, that means Talonflame wins. Talonflame is number one with the highest stats. Honestly, the only complaint I have about Talonflame is the Flame Body ability. I would almost be happier with something like Keen Eye or Intimidate even. Intimidate as a second option would be really nice for Talonflame, because Flame Body, excuse me, is really nice, but you're frail. You're not probably gonna be taking too many hits that you're gonna be able to make advantage of the Flame Body. But other than that, the speed is amazing. The stat total of 499 is amazing. The fact that you can be a mixed attacker, give you your options, great. Its level up moveset is a good mix. You got some special attacks, some physical attacks. You got Roost in there. You get Steel Wing, which by level up is great, because that help if you can kill the rock type before it kills you, I mean. And then with TMs, you can pick up the Flamethrower and the Fire Blast. It just, the diversity in Talonflame really made it number one for me. So, I'm going to quit rambling because I have a feeling this is going to be a long video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you would like to see more stuff like this, let me know. I had a lot of fun doing this. I have about 10 hours prep into this. I really put a lot of work into it. I really hope you guys enjoyed. Please leave a like. If you're new, if you would sub, that would be amazing. Well, as long as you enjoyed yourself. If you didn't enjoy yourself, that's fine. You're probably not even here anymore. So, if you didn't enjoy yourself, feel free to dislike. That's fine. But if you did, a like would be nice. A comment would be nice, too, letting me know what you guys think I did wrong or what you guys enjoyed about the video. But other than that, I will talk to you guys later.